it's important because it's information that's provided in our first language. It reflects our cultural values. It reflects our linguistic needs. And the reason we have a deaf interpreter on stage is that historically, sometimes you have a hearing interpreter on stage, and the hearing interpreter is following very closely to the English source, which doesn't really make a whole lot of sense to the deaf community members. This information needs to be conveyed in a way that the deaf community understands in order to gain equal access. So historically, there have been many communication barriers, particularly when it comes to media releases. And this way, with a deaf interpreter on stage, the deaf community is receiving that information with the appropriate linguistic and cultural modifications. And this, it also makes the deaf community feel connected to the information that's being given, especially when it's a very serious situation like what is being presented with right now. It's very important for the deaf community to have access to this information the same as hearing people do, at the same time and with the same level of accuracy. That's a very good question. Back in 1990, when I first received my training, I was so nervous as far as becoming a deaf interpreter was concerned. And every situation is so different, whether you're doing a legal appointment or you're in court or a conference or a medical appointment. There are so many variations. And even with being on stage, there's a lot to learn, and every situation is very unique. And when the deaf community sees me on stage or wherever it may be interpreting for them, they say to me, "Thank you. I'm not getting all the information I need from the captions." Sometimes the captions are incorrect or they're missing. And so this way I'm seeing the information in my own language, the way a deaf person would talk about it. And it eases their comfort level. It eases their stress. It's something that they enjoy watching, and it's something that they of course understand. And so when I'm providing that equal access, it makes me proud to be doing what I'm doing. It inspires me, and it has a great impact on the work that I do. And the deaf community is so thankful, and I'm thankful for the opportunities that I'm given whenever I'm asked to interpret. I love my work. We're co-workers. And I know many people ask, how does this process work? So what happens is that we have the hearing interpreter, Sandra, who listens to the source information in her first language, which is English, and she translates that into ASL, American Sign Language. And then I, using my knowledge of being a native language user and a cultural member within the deaf community, I know how that information needs to be conveyed to the deaf community. So when you have an English sentence, in English order of course we include all of that crucial information, but I also make the cultural adaptations. And so that's how I make this information accessible to the deaf community.